building a satellite is really cool, but what makes a satellite very personal or very linked to the university or to the country is that we get to fly our own developed technologies. And each of them are really interesting and quite diverse. We've got materials science, we've got sort of gamma ray astrophysics, and we've got software. And so you're kind of covering quite a wide range of technologies that hopefully will go on to be used in space in the future.
When I was in school, if I heard about Ireland's first satellite and knew that a team of students were building it in particular, I'd be extremely encouraged to follow a STEM career even more than I was. And it's just a really exciting and inspiring project to talk about and to hear about as well. So.
It started with my PhD student, David Murphy, and myself deciding in March 2017 to submit a proposal to ESA, who had put out a call for university teams to propose CubeSat projects. And Ireland has never had a satellite project, and we had been developing a lot of new experiments and capability in satellites and satellite subsystems through David's PhD and through our own research in the group. And we decided the time was right to make this bold proposal, and amazingly it was successful.
So EIRSAT-1 is a CubeSat, which is a type of miniature satellite. So you can think of it as a cube, and you can stack those cubes, you can make bigger satellites. So EIRSAT-1 is two of those cubes stacked on top of one another.
So many aspects to why this project is really important. That one certainly is the technical side, that we're learning an awful lot. The second is that we get to launch an instrument, our first instrument in space. We get to qualify it, see it, do all the tests in advance, learn all about that aspect, then launch it, operate it in space.
Well, one of the things I love about the project is the fact that we have 25 students, maybe, it varies from time to time, from many different disciplines, all very bright and able, but from different backgrounds, different characters. But we're all in this together, and we're highly interdependent.
So I've been part of EIRSAT since last 10 months, and I'm working on the antenna deployment module of the EIRSAT-1. So I do the mechanical testings associated with the ADM, specifically the thermal vacuum tests, vibration tests, and fundamental testings related to that.
So the antenna deployment module was designed here in UCD. The whole mechanism of how it works, it sits at the end of the satellite, and when we tell it to, it springs out four antennae, and that allows us to communicate with our ground station here in UCD.
So since EIRSAT's not in space yet, we can't listen to it from here using the ground station. So at the minute, we're testing using other satellites and we're tracking them as they go overhead. So our antenna system rotates around following one of these other satellites, and then our radio can listen to their transmissions.
So my role in the project is that I'm the assembly, integration and verification lead of the project. So basically I have to do a lot of coordinating between the assembly of the spacecraft as a whole and also the assembly of the individual subsystems or payloads.
So we have three payloads on EIRSAT-1. The main one is GMOD, the gamma ray module, which is going to detect gamma ray bursts in space. They're among the most distant things that we've ever seen. The further away you go in the universe, the further back in time you're looking. So gamma ray bursts are a good way to probe the very early universe.
You can take pictures of these really high energy photons that come from really energetic events in the universe. So when two stars collide or when a star dies, it releases a huge amount of energy, and that energy is emitted in gamma rays. And this is a kind of light that we can't see with our eyes, but our gamma ray detector can detect that light and turn that light into the light that we can see with our eyes. And then we feed that back down to the ground where we can and figure out more about these really explosive events in the universe.
So this is like a prototype version of GMOD. It's much larger than the one that's going to be in EIRSAT-1, but it has most of the same components. So the first thing that's very important is the scintillator crystal. What we're using is a crystal called cerium bromide. And what happens is that the gamma ray interacts with the crystal through photoelectric effects and other physical processes, and that generates tens of thousands of optical photons, photons that you could actually see. The second one is EMOD, which is the EMBIO module, which is testing EMBIO's solar black and solar white spacecraft coatings. They're on solar orbiter heading towards the sun, but this is the first time that they're going to actually be tested in low Earth orbit.
So EIRSAT, every 90 minutes, EIRSAT will orbit the Earth, and for half that it'll be in sunlight and for half that it'll be in eclipse.
One of the big areas that we look at in engineering is the attitude determination and control systems. We call it ADCS for short, and that's about the satellite knowing where it is in space.
So the flight software controls everything EIRSAT-1 will do when it's in space. We only communicate with EIRSAT for about 30 minutes a day, so EIRSAT has to do things automatically for the rest of the time and make sure that it's able to react if something happens, and that all has to be automated. So the software is basically controls all of those operations and those decisions that EIRSAT has to make.
Attitude is the orientation of the satellite in space. How are we going to control it? Well, it's interesting. We have current coils, electrical current coils in the sides, the faces of the satellite. So there are solar panels and the coils are going around the solar panels. We put a current through those coils that produces a magnetic field, and that magnetic field interacts with the Earth's magnetic field and produces a torque. It's called a torque, a turning action. And that's the way we're going to turn the satellite.
ESA are very adamant that this is going through basically the same set of steps that any ESA mission goes through in a somewhat streamlined version.
To put something into space, you have to meet stringent standards. There are several areas in which these standards apply.
Testing involves shaking and baking, they call it. So first you put it on a shaker, which gives it the vibration that it'll experience in the launcher.
There's also the environment. Thermally is quite hostile. It goes from hot to cold as you go into the sun, then back into eclipse. So you have to go through what's called thermal cycling. So the spacecraft has to survive that. The payloads have to survive that. That can be quite a challenge.
And also we have to do functional tests. We need to make sure that each board works and interacts with our software that's on our onboard computer.
And everything that you put up there, it can't affect anything else that's up there. It's maybe the case that we're going to launch from the International Space Station. So from that, you've got astronauts there, and you've got to make sure that everything you put up into space is absolutely safe.
So this is a Class 8 clean room, which means that there's less than 100,000 particles that are really, really small, so dust particles. And basically the whole purpose of EIRSAT having a clean room is that we keep dust and other contaminants off our flight hardware. So ideally when you go to space, you don't want any contaminants on the spacecraft that could eventually clog up systems or, you know, disperse on your solar panel and reducing the efficiency.
One thing about the EIRSAT-1 project is that we have people from every sort of background. I never imagined that I'd be doing this when I started my studies.
EIRSAT is the start of collaborative space research here in UCD.
It's going to be the beginning of a flourishing, I think, of new ideas, new innovations and new capabilities in space for Ireland.
Hopefully there's something for everyone, because it does take every sort of person to build a satellite.